Hello and how's it going? My name is Devrin, here to go through some more awesome information with you today. So, before we get started, remember to like, comment, and subscribe down below. And in today's video, I'm going to talk to you about different questions to ask your real estate agent before hiring, as well as after hiring. So stay tuned, I'll go through all the questions, that way you're more prepared and more knowledgeable so you can hire the best agent for you. So here's a couple of good questions to ask your real estate agent if you're looking to list your home or sell your home. One of the first questions to ask your agent before listing your home with them is, how many homes do they actually sell? You're gonna wanna get an agent that has a good track record and sells a lot of homes. The average agent sells between 6 to 8 homes a year. And so you gotta think to yourself, if this agent sells 2 homes, you're getting a below average agent. If you're getting an agent that sells 7 homes, you're getting an average agent. And if you get an agent that sells 100 homes, well, you got a pretty good agent on your hands. One of the other questions to ask is, what is their list to sell ratio? Which basically means, out of all the homes that they're listing, how many are they actually selling? It's one thing to take a bunch of listings or have a bunch of homes on the market as an agent, but if you're not actually selling them, it one, does your clients no good, and B, it does yourself as the agent no good because you're not making any money and you're not getting results, you're harming your track record, and that's just terrible. So as a seller, you wanna know how many homes out of all the listings he has is that agent actually selling on a percentage basis. Number 3 is, what is the list to sale price? Meaning, what is the percentage of the price that the home is listed at and what it actually sells for? So if you're getting an agent that lists homes for X dollars, but sells them for way down here, that might not be the best thing. You typically want an agent that's gonna have a list to sale price that's in the 95% plus, meaning his homes sell for 95% of what they're listed for. So if they're listed at $100,000, they're selling for $95,000. A couple other questions to ask your listing agent is, have they sold many homes in this neighborhood? And also, have they sold many homes in this price point? Because if you're gonna be marketing a $300,000 home, that's gonna be very different than marketing a $3 million home. Also, marketing in those neighborhoods are gonna be different in those areas. Now, back in the day, it used to be that agents had to be super hyper duper duper local, meaning they like worked in those areas and in those neighborhoods and they knew everything about it and they worked with everybody in that neighborhood only, and all those people knew them and they were at all the neighborhood parties, and that's how it all went. In today's market, you don't have to be hyper local, and largely that's due to the internet. You don't have to be an agent that specializes in one neighborhood. You actually want to be able to sell homes in a variety of neighborhoods and a variety of different price points. And so if you're interviewing an agent and they sell 500 homes, but they're selling them all over the place in regards to your Metroplex and in regards to price point, that's okay because it shows he knows how to sell a home regardless of the location and regardless of the price point. And ultimately, that's what you want. You want someone that can get the job done no matter the home. Another question to ask your real estate agent, and this is a massive one, whether he's a listing agent or whether he's a buyer's agent, meaning working with sellers or with buyers, is, are you part-time or are you full-time? Think about going to the doctor. And if you go to the doctor, do you want a doctor that's like a side gig doctor that only does this part-time? Isn't really into it, isn't very specialized. No, you want the best dang doctor you can get. And the same thing goes with a real estate agent. You want someone that's full-time, that is in the industry, living and breathing real estate. That way they can give you the best service possible. Another thing to ask your agent is if they are a solo agent or if they're on a team. And this is a big deal because solo agents are their own agent. They do their own thing. They do everything from listing the home, marketing the home, negotiating the price, putting the sign in the yard, printing out the media, designing the ads, working with the title company, the lending company, everything in order to get your home to sell. Versus a team, they'll have someone that meets with you to explain the whole process. They might have someone that helps you with the negotiations or with any repairs that need to be done, help you with the title company and with the lending company and all those different things. That's really beneficial because you get a specialist in each area that you're working with. Much like a doctor's office, you talk with the receptionist, you talk with the nurse, you talk with the doctor, and probably like 1,000 people in between. And so working with a team is very good because you're working with someone that specializes in that specific thing that you're needing to get handled. The last two questions that are super important to ask your real estate agent is, one, how are you gonna market the home? What is your plan? And how are you gonna get my home sold? And hopefully, he has a very strong internet marketing plan. The reason is because 90% of all buyers start looking for a home online. So you want to have a very strong internet presence. You want to be able to get your home out on the market, on the internet, and you want people to be able to see your home. Especially somewhere like Texas, where I'm at, because we have buyers from New York, from California, and we have to be able to get our information out to them so they can see your home and want to buy it when they move to Texas, because everybody's moving to Texas. 1,000 people a day. And the last thing to ask your listing agent is, what are your realtor fees? How do they work? What is your commission structure? All commissions are negotiable, 100% they're negotiable. You want to know what you're paying for, how it's going to be paid, and when is it going to be paid. Most commissions are all going to be paid at closing, which means your agent gets paid when he gets a result, meaning your home sells, and what you're paying for that is what you need to be aware of. You want to know if they have just a straight commission, if they have any sort of transaction fees, any sort of photography fees, anything like that. Those are all questions to ask your listing agent. Hope that made a lot of sense. Now we're gonna talk about questions to ask your agent after you have hired them. Now we're gonna talk about questions to ask your agent after you've hired them, which these are just as important as the ones to ask before you've hired them. Now this question is going to apply to both a buyer's agent and a listing agent. You're gonna wanna ask them to explain the process from start to finish. As someone that's selling your home, you wanna know what the whole process looks like. And as a buyer for a home, especially a first-time home buyer, you want your agent to be able to explain and expound simply on what does it look like to buy a home? What is an option period? What is an earnest money or an escrow period? What does typically happen in the repair negotiations? All of that stuff. You want to know about it and you want them to be able to understand it so that you can understand and you know that there's no crazy things that are going to jump out and get you on the way through this whole process. Another question, this is very simple, but you want to know what is the best way to contact your agent. Is it best to call him? Is it best to text him or to email him or to Skype him or to MySpace him? What is the best way to contact them? Because that's going to be super important for you as you're seeing homes that you want to go look at or as you have questions about somebody that came through and did a showing on your home. So knowing how to contact your agent is super important. Make sure to get that information from him. Now here's two questions that are super important to ask your listing agent. And these are, what price will this home sell at? Not what price should I list it at, or what price should I put it on the market on if I just wanna let it sit there for ages. You wanna ask what price will cause this home to sell in the most time efficient manner. You wanna be able to actually sell your home and not just have it on the market, have people coming and looking at it and not actually selling it. And the other question you need to ask is, what do I need to do in regards to staging my home and also any needed repairs or cosmetic upgrades do I need to make in order to sell my home for top dollar? If that's your goal, that might include repainting some walls, maybe rearranging some furniture, maybe going and getting a storage unit and putting a bunch of old stuff, old things into that storage unit to declutter your home. Those are all things that you need to know so that your home shows the best and you get the highest value and highest offer possible on your home. And some agents, especially agents that are on large teams, will actually have a stager and a professional photographer schedule times to come out to your home, do the photographs, spend time with you staging the home and giving you recommendations as far as what to do to make it look the best. You want your home to look the most inviting possible. You're probably not gonna wanna have a lot of family photos up. You're not gonna wanna have a ton of things crammed into one room. You want less things so that it seems more and more open. Another question that you need to ask your listing agent, your buyer's agent, is what are your estimated closing costs? As a seller, you're gonna have more closing costs because you're gonna be paying the agents, both the listing agent and the agent that brings the buyer to buy your home. So you're gonna have typically more closing costs than the buyer side. The buyer is also gonna have their share of closing costs. Typically on the buy side, you're gonna have about 2 to 3% and closing costs. Those are gonna be aside from whatever the down payment is. So if you're putting 3% down as a buyer, you have 2 to 3% in closing costs, about 6%. On the sales side, if you're paying a 6% commission, which in Texas is typical, again, they're always negotiable, but at a 6% commission, you're gonna have also as a seller 2 to 3%-ish in closing costs, so you're looking at about 9%. So think 9% closing costs on the sales side and about 6% with a 3% down payment of closing costs on the buy side. So those are some costs that you need to be aware of. So that way you can actually calculate as a seller how much you're actually taking away from the sale of your home, and as a buyer, how much you actually need to bring to the purchase so you can buy the home. All right, everybody, hope you enjoyed that video. That was just some questions to ask your real estate agent. If you have any other questions you think you should ask, leave them in the comments below. Like this video, subscribe to it as well, and let's chat next time. See ya.